When learning about time complexity, the classic example to explain quadratic time complexity is to use nested for loops, where we have a first for loop that is repeated n times, and inside it, we have another for loop that is also repeated n times, and n times m is n squared. This is why this algorithm has an O of n squared time complexity. But does it mean that it's always the case when we have nested loops? Not really, and this is what we're gonna see in this video. First, we have the cases where it's obvious that it's not O of n squared. For example, when one of the loops is repeated a constant amount of times. Like here, the second loop is always repeated 3 times no matter the value of n, so we get 3n, and by ignoring the constant, we get O of n time complexity. We can also mention the case where we have an O of n instruction inside the inner loop. Switching for a character in a string, for example, we get n times n times n, where n is the length of str, for example, which is O of n cubed. So it's a cubic time complexity. Those are the explicit cases where it's obvious that the algorithm is not an O of n squared, but I want to talk about the cases where it's implicit, where it's kinda hard to identify the time complexity. Okay, let's suppose that we have an array and a hash map where the key is an element in the array, and the value is an array containing indexes where we can find it. For example, for this array, this is what the hash map would look like. Now we want to traverse it, so we would write something like this. We traverse the keys of the index map, and for each key, we traverse its indexes. Here you can see that we have nested loops. For the outer loop, in the worst case, it gets repeated n times, when the hash map has n keys, where n is the length of r. This case occurs when every value appears exactly once in the array. And for the inner loop, in the worst case, it gets repeated n times. This case occurs when all the elements of the array have the same value, because we can find that value in every index. Now that we've figured out the number of repetitions of each loop in the worst case, we would think that we just have to multiply and we get O of n squared time complexity. But here comes the tricky part. In reality, the case where all values are distant and the case where one value appears in n indexes can't happen at the same time, because the values in the hash map represent indexes of r, and an array of n elements has n indexes, not n squared. So no matter how is the hash map organized, like this, like this, like this, or like this, the total will always be n. So we will always traverse n elements only. This is why the time complexity is O of n and not O of n squared. A little recap on this, the hash map contains indexes of the array has n indexes, our algorithm is just traversing the hash map, so we will traverse n elements only, then the time complexity is O of n. To get O of n squared, the hash map would have to look like something like this, which is impossible because we have n indexes only. I know that I'm repeating myself, but you really need to understand this. No matter the values in the array, the hash map will always contain n elements in total. So even if we are using nested loops, the number of iterations will be n, not n squared. You want another example? No problem. But before, please take some seconds to like the video and to subscribe to the channel, if you want to do so obviously. Second example now, is the solution of smallest number after removing k digits problem. The problem says that we have an integer num represented by a string and an integer k, and we have to return the smallest possible number by removing k digits from num. For example, if num is 26,378,491 and k is 3, the smallest number by removing 3 digits is 23,491. I won't detail the whole solution here, but the idea to solve this problem is to use a stack. Then for each digit in num, we keep popping from the stack while the stack still has elements, our digit is smaller than the stack's peak, and k is greater than 0. After it, we push our digit onto the stack and we continue. We also have to remove trailing zeros after it, but now I just want to focus on this part of the code, where we have nested loops. If we consider n as the number of digits in num, then the outer loop will be repeated n times, and inside it, in the worst case, the while loop can be repeated n times, when we have to pop all digits. So once again here, we may think of just multiplying n by n and we get O of n squared time complexity. But don't jump to conclusions too fast, we first need to know what does our stack contain, and how many times, in general, can the while loop be repeated, in general, not in a single iteration. Our stack contains digits of num only, and you can see that each digit is pushed only once. You also know that at each iteration of the while loop, a digit has to be popped from the stack, and because we have n digits, then we can only pop n elements. This is why the while loop will be repeated n times in the whole process in the worst case, not n squared, so the time complexity will be O of n. A little recap on this, the stack can contain digits of num only, each digit can be pushed and popped only once we have n digits, the while loop will be repeated at most n times, then the time complexity is O of n. Now that we've seen two examples, what can we conclude? We can conclude that when analyzing time and space complexity, you really need to understand what is your algorithm doing. Try to not quickly jump to conclusions, that's the main advice that you can take from this video. Before ending this video, let me tell you that if you want to become better in time and space complexity analysis, you can take the 50 popular coding interview problems inside code course, because for each problem, we try to find different solutions while analyzing and comparing their time and space complexities. So don't forget to have a look at it, the link is in the description. We have reached the end of this video, please comment below if you have questions, I'll be glad to answer. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.